Today we're going to talk about the switch endstop for the Big Tree Tech SKR version 1.3. It's just a plain simple switch endstop that creates a contact between these two by actuating it like so. So in a moment I'm going to explain how to connect it to the board, but let me review real quick. We have our X minimum, our X max, our Y minimum, our Y max, our Z minimum, and our Z max. Here's a close-up of the Y axis for the X minimum and the Y minimum. As you can see down below on the silk screen for the board, you see V, G, and S. What that stands for is voltage for this pin, ground for this pin, and then signal for this pin. Okay, in order to connect the connector for the switch endstop, we need to connect it to the x-axis right here, and the red wire in this case is actually ground and the black is actually signal. For some reason they colored the wires a little different, so you just slide it into the notch connector and that's all you have to do. So in a second we're going to load the Marlin firmware, but before we do that we need to connect the big side of the USB serial cable to the board right here, and the small side we're going to connect to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep in a moment. And keep in mind that you need to have your TF drive inserted in order to do this so that we can copy the new firmware onto the board. And okay, now that we have the USB drive for the R version 1.3, you can see that it says firmware.cur. The reason that we can see the extension is because I've been basically disabled the hide extensions in Windows 10 so that we can see this instead of just firmware by itself. So now I'm going to go over to Atom with PlatformIO loaded, and I'm going to show you how to set up the firmware load for your endstop. So in previous tutorials, what I've done is I go over to Source, then I go to Core, then I go to Boards. And we're going to do a search in Boards for SKR. And the board that we're looking for is board underscore Big Tree underscore SKR underscore V1 underscore 3. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go back to configuration.h. And we're going to search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. Next, we need to check to see that we have the right setup for our serial port. And as you can see right now, it says 0, but we need to change that to a negative 1. Next, we're going to do a search on endstop. And down below, we have a couple of end stops that are enabled by default. So what we're going to do is we're going to enable by removing the comments for use ZMAX plug, the ZMAX end stop. Now, in previous tutorials, I've gone over a couple of things about the preventing float point situations. This is, I believe, a resistor that helps you avoid being either below or above the limit that you're looking for, but I could be wrong on that. And then down below, we have inverting. Now, if you watched my first tutorial on the basics for the SKR version 1.3, you saw that they all said that they were triggered. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the logic for one of these to say true so you can see what happens. And then I'm going to leave alone the X-axis because it's only two wires to create a circuit for the X minimum. So in order to get this ready to load, we need to go over to platform.ini, and down below it says environment_default. So it's our default environment. Currently it's set to a chipset that's ATmega 2560. That's a particular type of chip that we're currently not using. So we need to find the one that we're actually using. And by doing that, we can just scroll down here to find it real quick. And here it is. The LPC 1768 is the chipset for the SKR version 1.3. It's an ARM Cortex-M3. So we need to copy that and then bring it back up here. And for our environment variable, we're going to change the Mega ATmega 2560 to what we just copied, being the LPC 1768. So to upload, we need to press the upload button here, just like we would do in the Arduino IDE. And in a moment, we'll have to save it. And then I'll show you in another moment what will happen to the USB drive for the SKR version 1.3. Okay, now that it's finished actually compiling and is uploaded to the SKR version 1.3, we can double check to make sure that it compiled okay by going to toggle build panel. And as you can see, it says successful. So I'm gonna go over to the drive for the USB on the SKR version 1.3. And as you can see, there's a firmware.bin that's been loaded, as well as the firmware .cur. So I'm going to remove the USB drive for a second and then reinsert it, and I'll show you what happens. See, now it says firmware.cur. So that means that possibly the firmware did load from firmware.bin. So to verify it, we're going to go over to Pronterface in a moment, and we'll check to see if the changes that we made worked. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder. So we're going to open up Pronterface.exe. We're going to connect to the SKR version 1.3. So as you can see now, it says connecting, and then it says printer is online. So let's verify that we have the right printer by doing M115 for the firmware. And as we can see, it says Marlin bugfix-2.0.x. So the next thing we want to do is check to see that the end stops are there. So we're going to do M119. And press enter. And as you can see, the Wyman change that we made, where it's not connected, doesn't say triggered, so that's good. And the Xmin that we're connected to does say triggered, which seems odd. So maybe we need to swap the actual logic for this one to be open. So let's try the end stop and then do another M119. So I'm going to actuate it with my finger. And now I'm going to press M119 in Pronterface and see what happens. And now it says open. So let me remove my finger. Now let's do M119 again and see what happens. And now it says triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.